years of dreaming.
So I've been working on Orbital Reflector for about 10 years.
Months in production.
I've been working with the Nevada Museum of Art for about 3 years on it.
Frustrating launch delays.
It almost feels like a race, and then you're very close to the finish line, and then they change the finish line. You have to run a little bit further.
Orbital Reflector is now on view in the night sky.
It is an art piece in the sense that it is a provocation. You know, it's an art piece, you know, quite literally in the sense that it's a sculpture.
Orbital Reflector is definitely not your typical curatorial undertaking. It's really the partnering of a museum and an artist to realize a vision that's much greater than either entity in itself.
What did it take to get here? How did an artist, a team of museum professionals, and a few aerospace engineers shepherd a seemingly impossible idea into reality?
Here's my requirement. Here's what I designed. Here's my theoretical answer. And I have proven to myself and to you that I have sound manufacturing process and sound design. Because if either one is not correct, we will have problems.
Yeah. And we're running a heat sealer. It's going to come down the track, and it's going to weld those together.
The Orbital Reflector team started by building a balloon. Global Western was tasked with transforming rolls of thin polyethylene plastic into Trevor Paglen's vision.
The biggest challenge really is the material that you're working with, because it's very slippery and it's very fragile. It's strong, but humans are not as, you know, graceful. So every little bump could actually put a tear in the plastics.
Though the 100-foot-long, highly reflective, diamond-shaped sculpture gets all the glory, a balloon cannot travel to low Earth orbit alone. It needs a small box known as a CubeSat, a type of miniaturized satellite often used for space research.
The satellite is a rectangular cube, about a foot long, about 4 inches on side. The rails and the end packs are aluminum, just common 6061 aluminum. You've got circuit boards holding the ends in the right positions, and then you have on the outside of the circuit boards are what we call antenna boards that have these mounted patch antennas. Those are obviously circuit boards. And the sides are more PC board material that are arranged into a solar panel.
How reliable was this beautifully simple, highly provocative technical engineering feat? The tests would reveal.
We've built as much reliability into the spacecraft as we can. And so we have pretty high confidence that it will work. But at the same time, the world is a complicated place, and technology can be fickle, and space is hard.
The Orbital Reflector team gathered at a testing facility called Consolidated Laboratories to determine if the satellite would be sturdy enough to withstand the launch environment.
So we're going to look at the results of today's testing. Hopefully everything is green light, and then we're going to proceed into the assembly and fabrication of the flight unit one.
Yeah. Radio side out is my highest vote.
Right.
Timer side in. According
now, it was time to integrate the spacecraft into the low free flyer, the device that would transport the satellite to space.
And here she is. I can't believe these guys from spaceflight are not giving us a standing ovation on the magnificence of this spacecraft.
With the precision of a surgeon's hand.
Okay, Drew, how's that look?
Looks good.
Okay.
Switches are depressed.
Good.
The team worked alongside engineers from Spaceflight Industries to securely place the spacecraft in its orbit-bound vessel.
Okay, this might go for a couple minutes here. Okay, so these guys, pull these off.
After this critical moment, the team would not see Orbital Reflector again until it was orbiting the night sky.
Okay. We're closed.
I'm highly confident. I'm really happy with where it is right now.
I feel really good right now.
After years of labor, the time had come to let go. The fate of Orbital Reflector was in the stars.
It would not be possible for a private company to make an object like this just on their own. It would not be possible for a military to make a kind of functionless object like this just on their own. So this idea of making something that is really not useful to industry or not useful to the military is precisely the kind of thing that those industries cannot do, right? And that is precisely the kind of thing that art can do.
Orbital Reflector was scheduled to ride to low Earth orbit on Spaceflight Industries SSOA Small Sat Express aboard a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket.
4, 3, 2, 1. Lift off of the Falcon 9.
In addition to carrying Paglen's visionary artwork, the mission was historic in its own way, carrying 64 payloads from 34 organizations. This launch was the largest in U.S. history.
And there goes that fairing. And there you can see all 64 of those satellites on stage two headed to sun synchronous orbit.
After several months of delays, this historic mission finally achieved liftoff.
So as you can hear from the crowd cheers here, Falcon 9 has touched down for the third time.
And then what we have to do is start communicating with our satellite. So we find our satellite in the sky, start talking to it with a radio.
In a few short months, Orbital Reflector will disappear, leaving no trace except the indelible memory of this shared moment in history.
Orbital Reflector will be visible with the naked eye for only a relatively short period of time, but it's during that time that I really hope that audience of all ages, all over the world, will really be instilled with that sense of wonder that outer space and space exploration has brought to humanity for so long. That idea that there might be something out there, that we don't know really the vastness of the universe. And it's that sense of wonder, I think, that's very similar to that spark of creativity and that sense of wonder that the visual arts can bring to us.